And welcome into our first edition of Coach's Corner for the 2021 season. Head coach Bryan Pratt is our guest as we get you ready for the opener against Mansfield, Texas. And coach, it's good to see you again. It's good to have football back once again.
Yeah, we kind of had a harsh ending to the season last year. I think the last one of these that we did, we didn't know it was going to be our last one. So it's been a while. Glad to be back. Thank you for what you do.
Well, we appreciate the time as always. I wanted to start with, I guess, the motto, the saying I've seen and heard you talk about, it's not about me. Could you just kind of explain what that's, why that's the motto this year?
Well, I think that in today's day and age with the Twitter and social media and everything, everybody posting stuff about, you know, my highlight, my this, my that, when I'm committing, my, everything in our world is about, you know, an individual as opposed to being about the team. And this is the ultimate team sport. And, you know, so we came together. Coach Thompson really liked this motto and wanted to make sure our kids understand that for us to be the best we can be, we have to worry about our team more than we do ourselves. And that was kind of where I came from. Everybody's had this, you know, different mottos and stuff. And I've heard this one before, and it's a really good one. It represents our team well. It's not about me.
How much how beneficial will it be? I'll get it out eventually. To have a somewhat normal off season, you guys were going to 7-on-7s. You got the spring practices in. How huge was that for you guys?
Well, I mean, it's really big for us. With the, you know, last year this time we're getting ready to play on ESPN, and we have, you know, 5 or 6 sophomores that are starting, and they haven't had some spring ball, any summer activity, anything. So it was huge for us to be able to get those guys in and let them get some more work in. The speed of the game has changed a little bit for them. They feel a little bit more comfortable than they did last year, and that all helps with the grudge of us being able to have our summer, you know, and for us to have a sophomore quarterback that's starting, a sophomore running back's playing, a sophomore offensive tackle that's starting, makes it where it's, you know, really, really, really big deal for us to be able to give many reps for those guys over the course of the summer.
You know, I was looking at that on the roster, and it is kind of unique. You do have a lot of young players, but you also at the same time have a lot of experience, guys that have played a lot of reps for you last year.
Well, I mean, you look at our top dudes, and they're all guys that started for us as sophomores. You know, when you go through 10 games as sophomores, that helps you. When you step in as a junior, you feel like you're a little seasoned. And as I've said before, the speed of the game slowed down a little bit. And that's what just that experience gives them. We do feel like we have some experience. We're still playing a lot of young guys, which makes it good for us in the future.
Now, this game was supposed to happen last year when the Broken Arrow opportunity came up to play on national TV. It got moved to this season. Is that right?
It did. Actually, the reason why it all kind of got twisted is because of COVID. And in Texas last year, the large schools didn't start playing until mid-September. So, obviously, their games all got mixed up, and that's the reason we went back. This will be the last year of the Texas thing where they bring some schools to Oklahoma and Arkansas, and then we go back down there, et cetera. This will be the end of that. And so luckily for us, we didn't have to make the trip down there. So we got to use it at our advantage, you know, Friday as Mansfield comes in. It's a long trip from Mansfield, Texas, all the way up to Northwest Arkansas.
Yeah, and depending on what schedule you look at, this is Mansfield, Texas, not Mansfield, Arkansas, that's coming up here for this game. What do you know about them, and is it more about your guys getting ready to go than necessarily about a scouting report in week zero or game one?
Well, it's tough to put together a scouting report because you get them in a scrimmage for half of a game, and that's it. You don't really get any special teams or anything like that. And you know, so it is kind of hard to prepare for them. I know they're a large school in Texas. When I was in the Metroplex coaching, Mansfield was right next to us, so I'm kind of familiar with them. They've always had some really good players, and Mansfield's kind of like the Bentonville area. When I moved there in 2000, they had one high school and just opened the second one. And then 3 years later, 4 years later, whatever it is, they've got they've got four high schools. I think they have five now. So it's kind of crazy how much growth they're getting down there, because these aren't small high schools. These are large high schools. And so anytime you get a chance to play a Texas high school team, you know, you got to make sure you represent yourself, because, you know, they're going to be good, well coached, and come in and play hard.
All right, Coach, as always, good luck, and we appreciate the time here on Coach's Corner.
Appreciate you. Thank you for all you do.